A couple of weeks ago, I published Thomas and the Runaway, an adaptation of the scene from The Adventure Begins, which is an adaptation of the Railway Series story, Thomas and the Breakdown Train. My video also takes notes from the Series 1 episode of the same name, which is also an adaptation of the book. Got that straight? Good. You may remember I did a direct remake of The Adventure Begins version all the way back in 2015. How has it been 8 years? This was the first remake I ever did, and it certainly wasn't the last. I've always had a complicated relationship with remakes. They're fun to put together, and they are by far the most popular videos I've made. But it's also retreading old ground, and the scenes already exist in the show. I usually didn't add a whole lot of original ideas to them, with some exceptions. I truthfully don't foresee myself making many more standalone remakes. It's fun to reimagine iconic scenes, but I think my limited time is better spent working on something new. Since that 2015 remake kinda kicked off a new era of my channel, I thought it would be cool to start this wave of model content the same way. A lot of assets and props needed to be made or refurbished. I already made a video about Black James, so we'll move right along to Tidmouth Sheds. The sheds are only in the background of this video, but in order to appear, they had to be camera ready. I acquired this roundhouse kit back in like 2018 and didn't really do a whole lot to it for stupid reasons. For example, I like when the stones in the arches are painted a darker tone. But I had bought the sheds for some Series 3 inspired videos and ignored my own instincts in the name of accuracy. And even then I didn't fully commit to it either. But this time around, I was doing what I wanted to do in the first place. The sheds were in a bit of a sorry state. I had first assembled them with hot glue, and there were globs and strings everywhere. So I removed what I could and took everything apart again. When I put the sheds together for every engine, I'd never put doors on it. This time, I actually 3D modeled the doors and was lucky enough to have Lucas print them for me. It was difficult to remove them from their supports without snapping the window lattice, but he sent me a few spares, which I needed. I painted them green and honestly didn't worry too much about the backside. You'll never see it. Now there was still the matter of attachment. Brenden recommended that I use dollhouse hinges, and that proved to be the method. With the berths, my first job was filling the holes on the front, and then I started painting and weathering them. I used a mix of paint and weathering powders for this. Same method for the walls. The roof needed painting too. Plain plastic just was not going to cut it. The turntable needed brickwork, and that was added as well. The troublesome trucks up to this point still had hook and loop couplers, so I removed those, shaved down the plastic screw holes, and installed 3-link couplers. I then weathered every single one. I didn't have 3D printed faces for them, so I rounded up the ones I could find, which wasn't very many. As a rule for the new style, I didn't want some of the eyes to be poseable while others were painted. They're the same thing, so they should look the same. For the purposes of this video, I decided to repaint the Bachman faces and drill out the eyes. It looks a little rough, but for a high-speed chase, they'd be good enough. This video is the first proper one I've done since moving into a new filming space. A good friend is generously letting me use her garage. Thank you, Jan. I also had my friend Jacob's assistance for some of the filming, specifically the tunnel sequence.
Here we go. No, come on. No. We're going.
This would have been a lot trickier to pull off on my own. Obviously, I'm working at a smaller scale than the original show. I wish I could work in Gauge 1, but HO is just more practical. Since the models are smaller, it's especially challenging to make them look larger. The camera's pretty big and can't get very low. Turning it upside down doesn't really help much in this case. I had showed a draft of this video to my friends while I was filming, and after some feedback from Brenden and Lucas, I approached the new shots with extra intention. I built a set specifically for tracking shots, with the tracks elevated on the edge of the board so I could get up close. The Tidmouth scene was after this, and I applied a similar strategy, having the characters positioned on the edge of the set. As you can see, I didn't always have the full ensemble going at the same time. James's full train wasn't crazy long, but it took up most of the set. It required some innovation to get him and his train to go off screen. James's crash was complicated for a couple of reasons. I didn't want to use the 3D printed running board since the resin would certainly not withstand the carnage, so I swapped that with one from Busy Bee James. I didn't cut off the smoke box supports though, and you can kinda tell. but for casual viewing, I don't think it's too unforgivable. It was also complicated because every shot meant I had to set up the crash again and again. The trucks, James, and even the ground. I put down a layer of dirt under the ground cover so that the impact felt more realistic. I'm always learning something new anytime I try a challenging scene like this one. Watching it back, I can also see things I'd like to do better on the next video. The positive response from you guys was so appreciated, and it's a big part of what makes doing this fun. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.